HPV and cervical cancer screening with the pap smear, just because recently in the past, I want to say between 5 and 8 years, the guidelines for pap screening have changed. We're starting screening later, and we are screening less frequently. We used to screen teenagers, so basically starting from when they started having intercourse. So now universal screening is recommended that females, that pap smear screening should start at age 21, no matter what the girl's sexual history is. So for ages between ages 21 and 29, pap screening is recommended every 3 years if you've had normal pap smears. And then with the advent of HPV testing, which HPV is one of the viruses that causes cervical cancer, is responsible for about 95% of cervical cancer. With modern technology, we're able to test for some of the strains of HPV that can put you at high risk for cervical cancer. We now combine pap smears with HPV testing for women who are greater than 30 to give us a more sensitive way of detecting any abnormalities. Because we've added HPV testing with pap smears, women over the age of 30 can actually extend their screening to every 5 years if everything is normal. No matter what, even though the guidelines for pap screening is every 3 years or every 5 years, you should always go in to see your OBGYN or your primary care physician for a full annual exam every year. Just because they can detect if there's anything else abnormal with the pelvic region. Just because we're not doing a pap smear doesn't mean that nothing else can be going on down there. So I always recommend that even if you're not due for a pap smear, you go in every year just to get checked out.